Hello, hello, Jeff Helvin here with Balin Brands, and today I'm going to show you how to merge duplicate contacts into one. Now, in Infusionsoft, it's not uncommon to actually have two different people that might share the same email address or two people that have the same phone number, and so sometimes you'll come across duplicate contacts because that's not a default configuration in Infusionsoft. So I want to show you how to easily alleviate that if you do happen to come across an instance where you have two contacts that are meant to be the same. So in this case, I've created duplicate contacts for Tom Jones. So if I start to type up here, you'll see there's two different records. So if I just hit enter, it actually pulls up both contacts here. So one thing I can do is I can actually click each of the records, and under actions, I can say merge duplicate contacts. Now what's cool about Infusionsoft here is that it's actually going to show you the original contact that was in the system, the newer contact that was in the system, and then it has this column right down here in the middle that's showing what the merge contact will look like when I'm done. So what I get to do is I get to actually choose which information that I want to keep between the two contacts. So it could be first, last name, and email over here on the original contact, and then it might be phone number and other information here on the new contact, and I can merge those both into one contact, one new contact. So what it does by default is it's actually going to put in the most recent information. It assumes basically if there's two different email addresses, on the left I have Tom at TomJones.com, and on the right I have Tom at Jones.com. So what it's going to assume is that if this is more recent, then this information must be more up to date. Now, there are occasions where we might know different, and so we choose to override that. So if you notice here, it's going to keep the original contact. Its first name is the same on both sides. Last name is the same on both sides. And then we have Tom at TomJones.com. And then on the right, we have Tom at Jones.com. So let's say I actually know that the Tom at TomJones.com is a better email address. I can just hit these little arrows, and you'll see it'll populate it right here in the middle. Now, next, we have phone number. So we might say, oh, okay, this was the original phone number, and this is the new phone number. So let's just go ahead and say, okay, yeah, that is the new number. He wants to be contacted at his work number, and this is that number. And then anything else, since there are no values here on the right side for the rest of these fields, we're actually going to see that we have these pre-filled here on the left go right into there. So in this particular case, you get to see, like I said, each of the different fields on the left side, on the right side, and then in the middle, you're going to have that. So then finally, we're just going to go ahead and hit merge and view contact. And we just want to confirm, yes, we understand it's permanent. And now you'll have one record that has the correct information. Now the other thing it does is it actually will merge any other things like tasks. So if you had tasks on one record and tasks on another record, it's just going to combine the two. If you had notes on one record and another record, it's going to combine the two. Any email communication between the two that were on both different accounts, again, it's going to merge those. So everything else comes along with it. You're just choosing which data to collect. So I hope that's helpful when you manage your database here. Again, Jeff Helvin with Balin Brands. We love Infusionsoft, and we'd love to help you. Give us a call or reach out to us via email, team@balinbrands.com.